I believe that if we are honest with ourselves, that the most fascinating problem in the world is, who am I? What do you mean? What do you feel when you say the word I, myself? I don't think there can be any more fascinating preoccupation than that, because it's so mysterious, it's so elusive. Because what you are in your inmost being escapes your examination in rather the same way that you can't look directly into your own eyes without using a mirror. You can't bite your own teeth. You can't taste your own tongue, and you can't touch the tip of this finger with the tip of this finger. And that's why there's always an element of profound mystery in the problem of who we are.
Not worrying what other people think is the greatest form of self-love. When self-love is absent, you will always be worrying what other people think. People that love themselves, we see them all the time in the world, and they're smiling. They're letting go of fear, letting go, and they are soaring to phenomenal heights. The more your self-love increases, the more your self-expression increases.
This problem has fascinated me for many years, and I've made many inquiries. What do you mean by the word I? And there is a certain consensus about this, a certain agreement. Ego, myself, my source of consciousness, to be a center of awareness and of a source of action that resides in the middle of a bag of skin.
Reggie Jackson struck out 2,600 times in his career, the most in the history of baseball. But you don't hear about the strikeouts. People remember the home runs. Fall forward. Thomas Edison conducted 1,000 failed experiments. Did you know that? I didn't know that. Because the 1,001st was the light bulb. Fall forward. Every failed experiment is one step closer to success. You've got to take risks, and I'm sure you've probably heard that before. You will fail at some point in your life, except you will lose. You will embarrass yourself. You will suck at something. There's no doubt about it. And I know that's probably not a traditional message for a graduation ceremony, but hey, I'm telling you, embrace it, because it's inevitable. And I should know.
Life, and I started thinking about this conference and what we're about, and I looked back and I thought, well, I was two people my whole life. I was in the living room entertaining people, being among people, you know, doing my thing for the company and trying to relieve my mother, who was suffering. She had arthritis and vitis and everything under the sun that was nagging at her, and she was depressed. And I wanted her to be free. And I wanted her to realize that her life was worth something because she gave birth to someone who was worth something.
And so, we have what I have called the conception of ourselves as a skin-encapsulated ego. Now, it's very funny how we use the word I. If we just refer to common speech, we are not accustomed to say, I am a body. We rather say, I have a body. We don't say, I beat my heart, in the same way as we say, I walk, I think, I talk.
Thank you.